I feel like I should be rowing, getting somewhere. No.
But in the NFL, with the competition as it is tough to win a Super Bowl. I mean, all you need is good grapes and a good winemaker to produce a great wine.
The coolest thing about shooting a reality show is that, you know, they shoot reality. And what's been so great is actually being able to share with, you know, my fans and just our audience how much I love wine and then also, you know, our wine.
You don't need to speak a language to enjoy a wine. It's like any type of art. It speaks to your soul.
So teamwork, team effort, team building is critical to winning in the NFL. That's exactly the same case with making a cult style, special, unique Cabernet Sauvignon wine.
You know, our daily lives, we're on the go all over. And, you know, when you go to the winery, right, I mean, you're hands-on. I mean, you truly are hands-on. There's no, you know, you can only do so much with machines. Mm-hmm. And so there's so much you do with we do with our hands, and we really enjoy that.
So when Journey asked me to join them and come and live in the Bay Area here, I thought, well, now it's my business to learn about it. I think the rhythm of winemaking certainly has a lot to do with music.
It was originally headed for the freezer, but he's so sweet and so affectionate and cute that he's now just a very, very large pet.
Well, I started in real estate, appraised a piece of property one time and had a vineyard on it, and I thought that was the coolest thing ever. 12 years ago, real estate kind of took a backseat to growing grapes and making wine.
Soon after I was able to taste wine, I started looking for flavors in wine and food that went together. And that's really where my passion for wine pairing began.
I was hired to pick grapes for a friend who wanted to make wine. And that year didn't go so well. The picking was difficult and the wine turned to vinegar, but it was great for tie-dyeing. So we tie-dyed a bunch of t-shirts and ties and stuff and then got on the green tortoise and went for a ride.
I've heard some people say, oh, this is the best area and that's the best area. But the fact is they're all great wines, but they vary, they're different. And that's why it's fun to try to, if you can get the grapes, to try to make wines from different parts of the valley.
You have to make sure you're always making money. Yes, it's about having fun, but it's really not fun if you're not making any money doing it.
I was up in Napa Valley and I was in a tasting room with one of the fragrances that I was working on. And the winemaker said, "Who's wearing perfume in my tasting room?" And I said, "Oh, sorry, it's me. Is that okay?" And he said, "You should never wear perfume when you're sipping wine." And I went back to my fragrance studio and I blended 5 different fine fragrances that were all inspired by the notes of wine.